بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين بإذن الله. Today we'll be speaking about how a Muslim can build his or her confidence. Yesterday we spoke about overcoming fear. When it comes to this topic, we've got to realize that there's a difference. As Muslims, we differentiate between confidence and ghurur. Ghurur is where a person is arrogant. They love themselves a bit too much, and this drives them to thinking that they are better than everybody else, and at times oppressing people, looking down on people, thinking that they are the best and nobody else can come close to them. We are not talking about this. This is ghurur, and this is something which is actually a sickness of the heart, and it needs to be cured and addressed. The confidence we want to speak about is where a person develops confidence knowing that bi-ithnillah they have something good to give, they have something of benefit. Yet at times you find people are shy, or they fear, or maybe it's because of the environment, so they stay back or they hold themselves back, even though they know at times that certain positions or certain tasks that are given to other people and they had an opportunity to do it and they would have done a better job, they don't take them. Why? Because of this fear or nervousness. So this is what we want to speak about, and we want to speak about how a person can build their confidence bi-ithnillah, and they can take action and move on. When we look at the lives of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, we will find that yes, they were the best of people. After the Anbiya alayhimus salatu wassalam, they feared Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They had the best of deeds. In fact, you would find them the best of people after the Anbiya. They actually would fear that do they have the correct iman, or they would fear from hypocrisy. But when it came to action, when it came to doing something that was good, if any of them had the ability to do good, they knew they had the ability and the capacity, or they knew something, they would have the courage and the confidence to go forth and do it or say that which was right. For example, look at Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. He was a young boy, yet Umar radiallahu anhu would bring him into the gathering where the seniors or the older people were. So much so, some of the people told Umar radiallahu anhu, how can you let this child come in by us? And Umar radiallahu anhu said, he is more knowledgeable, he knows a lot. The other people were asking for their own children to be allowed, and Umar radiallahu anhu was telling them that this child, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he is different, he knows things. Then we all know the story, how he asked him about the tafsir of إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. He first asked the people who were gathered, what do you think this verse means? And they gave a literal translation. As for Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, as a child he was able to say that I think that this is an indication to show that the life of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam is coming to an end. Where does this tie in with confidence? Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu had the knowledge, but he also had the courage and the confidence to speak up, especially when it came to a gathering where there were people who were older than him. He had knowledge and also the courage. A lot of the times you find people who have good skills, they have good knowledge. At times they're able to do certain tasks, but because they're shy, they're nervous, they're scared to make a mistake, they don't do it. So look at Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. In fact, another Sahabi, the best of companions, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, after the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed away, we all know that Umar radiallahu anhu said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam has not passed away. And whoever says anything opposite to what I've mentioned, there would be such and such. Everybody listening to Umar radiallahu anhu, and he was a man who was feared, a strong man, an intelligent man. Yet Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, when he came and he realized, he stood up and addressed the people. He was the most knowledgeable, but this also took courage. He had confidence. He knew what he was going to say was correct. He had an ayah from the Quran. He went up and he spoke. In fact, in another hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, we find Umar radiallahu anhu encouraging his son, Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, to have spoken up, to have had the courage and the confidence. One day they were sitting with the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he asked the companions about a tree which is similar to a Muslim. And Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, who is narrating the hadith, he says that, and amongst the people were the seniors, Abu Bakr and Umar and others, and nobody knew the answer. And I felt in my heart that it was a palm tree, but I didn't speak, I didn't answer. And nobody spoke, nobody knew the answer. So the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam then told him that it is a palm tree. He says, after that, I went and I told my father. I said, you know what? I knew the answer. It was in me, but I didn't speak. What did Umar radiallahu anhu say? This was a youngster. Amongst the seniors, Umar radiallahu anhu said, I wish you had spoken. It would have been more beloved to me than this and this, or so and so many. It would have been something great and something important. So look at how the youngsters from the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, where they knew and they had knowledge, they spoke like Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhum, or they were encouraged to speak or to talk like how Umar radiallahu anhu was telling his son Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. As Muslims, when it comes to the topic of building confidence, inshallah, we'll mention 7 things that a Muslim can bear in mind and practice upon. And inshallah, it will help you to build your confidence bi-idhnillah. The first is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, as a Muslim, you don't think that, you become proud and boastful and you think, I am it. Or you feel like, you know what, there is nothing to do with the Creator, like how some people believe. And they think that everything is in my hands, and as long as I do X, I expect a result of Y, for example. No, remember, everything comes from Allah. So the first thing is you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Him to grant you humbleness, humility, and also courage and confidence to do that which is right. So the first step, or the first point we mentioned to build your confidence, is to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second is, as we mentioned before, look at the lives of the best of creation. Ponder over the Quran. Ponder over the Sunnah. Look at the words of Allah, the words of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Read the biographies of the Anbiya, the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, pious people, those who were successful. Even when it comes to biographies of people who live today, you see somebody who's successful, you relate to them. Look at how they went about doing the things. You'll find a lot of times, if not all the time, you find somebody who's successful, they had to have had some sort of courage and confidence. So when you read these biographies, you'll be able to benefit from them. You'll be able to see so many times how they had to go against the herd mentality, or what's known as common thinking, where people said it was impossible. These few people thought it was possible, and they had the confidence and the courage to carry it out. The third point when it comes to trying to build your confidence as a Muslim, try to change your environment. Your environment, those around you, at times, if not, then who you're following on social media, what you read, what you allow to enter into your ears, what you consume, basically. When you're around people who think everything is impossible, when you're around people who are shy and afraid, at times you take that character or that trait. However, if you change your environment and you start looking and interacting or sitting with people who are confident, who want to do things, who want to get things done, you'll find bi-idhnillah that will have a good and positive effect on you. We all know the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, where he speaks about good company. One should be with people who are good. So that is the third point. The fourth point, which is mentioned a lot by the psychologists, and when pondering over the Sunnah, you can find a few examples of this. They say that in order for motion to occur, in order for a person to get their emotions in check, they should carry out something. They should take action. They say motion is a precursor to your emotions. So a lot of the times, this is something mentioned by psychologists, people have their own opinion. When we look at the Sunnah, we find this and we find that. So we find these few examples where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam is telling us to do certain actions and telling us if we do it, we will develop a certain trait. For example, in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, وَمَن يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهُ. Whoever wants to be patient. So they try their hardest. They try to become patient. Allah will grant him patience. What does this mean? Think deeper and ponder over the hadith. It doesn't mean that if you want to become patient, that you know what you think about it and that. No, you have to start doing it. And bi-idhnillah, as you do it, you will develop that trait. Allah will make it easy for you. So when you look at other things you want to do in life, let's say you're scared of talking in front of people. The only way you'll do it is start talking. You'll make some mistakes, you might forget, but slowly that will develop your confidence. So the action you take, bi-idhnillah, it will help you to develop your confidence. The next point is when it comes to building the thoughts you have. Always think well, think positively. A lot of psychologists speak about your brain or your mind and your thoughts being like a bank. What's the job of a bank? As a customer, you go to the bank, you put in money and you take out money. So same when it comes to your mind, you put in thoughts and experiences and you withdraw them. Successful people, you would find that everybody goes through things that are difficult, hard, they made mistakes, people criticize you, people speak about you. However, they don't let that affect them. They don't deposit these bad experiences. It comes, it passes, and they leave it. Good experiences, they keep with them. Because whatever you deposit in it, in your mind, in the same way in the bank, what you deposit in it, you will be able to withdraw. So you find, for example, we spoke about speaking. Let's say a person goes the first time and they speak. They make a mistake or they stutter or they haven't prepared and they have one of the worst experiences ever. A person who takes this thought and this experience and deposits it in their mind every time they want to speak in the future, the only thing they will draw on or they will withdraw is this bad experience. So don't deposit bad thoughts and bad experiences. Only look at that which is good and that which is positive. Think about the good things and think about that which is positive. And the next point we want to speak about when it comes to building a person's confidence is look at your body language. In a hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Al-mu'minu al-qawiyyu khayrun wa ahab." Basically, the strong believer is better and more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than a weak believer. This is not only when it comes to iman. Yes, that's the main thing. But also when it comes to your strength, your physical strength, that entails courage and confidence. So be somebody whose body language is positive, who wants to do things. A lot of times when you look at people, or you find the way people sit and the way people walk, you can see if they're going through sadness, if they're going through difficulty. Some people walk and they look down in a way which it's like they don't want to live. They are a corpse who is walking. So we should look at that. And in fact, there's studies to show that if you change your posture, if you try to change the state you are in, exercise, etc., you find yourself feeling much better. Bi-idhnillah. The last point when it comes to this, you'll find building confidence. Don't worry about what people have to say. This topic, or the topic of worrying about people, what people have to say, what people, when people may criticize you, it's a large topic. But what we're talking about is not when you make a mistake or when you've done something wrong. Everyone will make a mistake and do something wrong. People will criticize you. It's right, take it. Even at times, if the uslub or the way they did it, the way they corrected you is not the right way. However, we're talking about where people don't want to do something because they're scared. This person will laugh at me. That person will say this. That person will say that. Don't worry about what they say. When you start something, you won't be the best at it. In fact, you may not even be good at it. But you have to carry on and you have to persevere. Today we spoke a little bit about building confidence for those who are tuning in now. Inshallah, we'll try and keep these topics going. Inshallah, tomorrow we'll speak about a new topic. Maybe it will be on finance. We will carry on with the other series or seeking knowledge. Bi-idhnillah. With those few words, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all goodness, beneficial knowledge. Grant us all confidence and courage in a way which pleases Him. Not making us those who think we are arrogant or we know everything or we look down on people. No. Rather, confidence and courage that helps us to do good and be those who are exemplary and role models to others. With those few words, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to benefit us all. Ameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.